feeling as though he's in control against Emmanuel Lucero.
Bago umakyat sa featherweight division, ay dinepensahan muna ng ating pambansang kamao Manny Pacquiao ang kanyang IBF Super Bantamweight World Title sa huling pagkakataon taong 2003. Ito nga ay kontra sa undefeated Mexican boxer at sinasabing susunod na superstar sa Super Bantamweight division na si Emmanuel Lucero. Si Emmanuel Lucero ay former WBC Continental Americas Super Bantamweight Champion. At ang laban kay Pacquiao ang unang beses na lalaban nito sa isang world title. Kaya naman gigil na itong makasuntukan ang ating pambansang kamao. Habang ang laban naman kay Emmanuel Lucero ay ang ikaapat at huling pagdidepensa ni Manny Pacquiao sa kanyang IBF Super Bantamweight title. Ang laban ng dalawa ay ginanap sa Olympic Auditorium sa California, USA. At bago ang kanilang bakbakan, ay may baong kartada si Manny Pacquiao na 36 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw at may 27 KO. Habang si Emmanuel Lucero naman ay may malinis na kartada noong 21 wins, 0 loss, 1 draw at may 12 KO. Bagamat mas lamang sa boxing experience ang ating pambansang kamao, ay pagyayabang naman ni Lucero na 10 taong pa lamang daw siya ay lumalaban na daw siya sa street fighting sa Mexico.
He became a street fighter, but he did it for money. At the age of 10 and 11, he was getting paid $10 for street fights by a local promoter.
Sa unang round ay kaagad na umatake na parang torong nanunuwag si Emmanuel Lucero.
That broke apparently without help.
Well, if you read between the reports, which I'm quite sure we did, I believe there's some truth to some of that.
Lucero gets off a moment with Pacquiao pinned in the corner, and the crowd responds. Lucero, originally from Mexico, said he will have the support.
It's almost like a crowd where he's dropping it extremely low, and actually, according to the rules, you're not supposed to go below your opponent's waistline, which he's did on a few occasions.
Now Pacquiao straightens him up with a left hand, and Pacquiao pins him against the ropes. Pacquiao managing to do most of the damage here in an odd and awkward first round.
And he's trying to time him about the weave and trying to shoot his left uppercut now as he sees him going down.
Lucero, increasingly defensive, hasn't thrown that many punches in the second half of the round. As we go to the corners, there will be interpreters in...
Never been in a fight against a major fighter.
Copy box numbers in round one. Pacquiao landing 16 out of 64, including 7 of 29 jabs. Lucero was only 5 of 41. If Manny can keep finding a way to throw nearly 30 jabs in the round, I'm not sure how Lucero is going to get at him effectively, Emmanuel.
No, Lucero can't do too much effectively, and especially when it comes to throwing combinations when you crouch it.
Lucero was supremely confident in his discussions with us yesterday. May have underestimated the hand speed of Pacquiao, as some opponents do. Taking advantage of a slow break at the end of that clinch to hit Lucero with a left hand over the top. Seems to have momentarily stunned Lucero. Now Pacquiao tries to continue the attack. It's going to be physically exhausting for him to try to stay down in that crouch.
Absolutely.
Slow in this round. Body shot by Pacquiao and a big left hand. Again with the body, Lucero just taking the punishment and trying to duck away.
Not more.
Lucero won a lot of amateur fights with this style. Golden Glove Championships, New York State Amateur Championships. He must have just overwhelmed people.
When you have a guy fight punch swinging like that, the best thing, make him miss completely. That way he loses his balance. You don't block his punches, you just let him miss completely.
Pacquiao lands the straight left hand again. Fight has been one-sided in terms of meaningful contact, as virtually all of the real scoring blows have been landed by Manny Pacquiao. Pacquiao's trainer, Freddie Roach, argues that his 122-pound fighter struggling to make weight would be a threat to knock out 126-pound kingpins Eric Morales and Marco Antonio Barrera. Your take?
I think he would definitely be a threat for both of those guys.
Ullman. Copy box numbers in two. Pacquiao, great round, 31 out of 66. Lucero, virtually non-existent, 4 out of 42. Pacquiao landing nearly 60% of his power shots through the first two rounds. And there's more accurate punching from Manny Pacquiao against a pretty tough target to find. Finally, Lucero gets in a counter left.
Even if Lucero lands a punch, it may look impressive the way he swings. I don't think it's going to hurt Pacquiao because you can see it coming. Punches that you see coming don't hurt you. The punches that you don't see that hurt you.
Now, you can tell when Pacquiao's supremely confident, he fights with a little smile on his face, and he's been grinning through most of the first two rounds here, feeling as though he's in control against Emmanuel Lucero. And after that punch, he is totally in control.
Matapos tamaan ng pamatay na kaliwa ni Pacquiao sa panga, ay parang nalasing sa pagkahilo si Emmanuel Lucero. Kaya naman kaagad na itinigil ng referee ang laban.
He is totally in control and the referee instantly stops the fight.
He was out on his feet with a punch that landed right on the point of the jaw.
Jose Cobian taking no chances whatsoever. No count. Comfortable in LA. You can see there's the left hand that starts to Lucero standing up.
He never saw the punch coming. He was too low to even see it coming. He thought he was probably out of danger by getting that low.
Gives you a pretty good idea as to how heavy are Manny Pacquiao's hands.
Yes, and it's good focus and concentration too.
And the referee stoppage was aimed at protecting Lucero from another shot, because Lucero was a sitting duck target there for Pacquiao.
Yeah. Pacquiao was timing his move.
The winner by TKO victory and still the IBF Junior Featherweight Champion of the World, Manny Pacquiao.
Matapos talunin si Emmanuel Lucero, ay tuluyan ng umakyat sa featherweight division ang ating pambansang kamao. At doon ay nakasagupa niya agad si Marco Antonio Barrera, kung saan tinalo niya ito sa pamamagitan ng 11th round TKO.
I wouldn't send him out for the 12th round, Manny. I don't care how proud he is. There's no way a great fighter should have to go through three more minutes of this.
No, because Pacquiao is not backing off. If you had a guy that was
he's
holding
been hurt.
Up.
Here comes gotcha. Barrera's corner. Barrera's corner, man, is up on the apron. He's going to step into the ring. That's a good decision.
Great finish by Pacquiao. A valiant effort.